Moorhead's getting a lot of calls from Southside homeowners who don't understand what the city's doing to prepare for the next crest. Some of those at a neighborhood meeting today said they don't see why dikes are needed since their homes stayed dry in 1997. Chief David Ebinger says they're trying to prepare for the worst with what he called a redundant belt and suspenders approach. Mayor Mark Boxland says much of the city is at 40 and a half feet, including his own home and those of these people. City leaders say Southside primary dikes are up to about 43 feet and they think they will hold. However, anyone who decides to stay in their home behind the contingency dikes during the next crest is asked to let Moorhead police know.
You can see the surreal life Shauna Olschlager's been living, from packed bags to stacked boxes, all over her living room.
We've been in the midst of it now for 2 weeks.
She's bracing herself for the second crest, and maybe a second evacuation. She's walled in with her two boys.
A flood, and what happens with all the water with a flood? Where does it go?
And walled in with the rest of her neighbors by the contingency dikes.
Some good news to tell everybody. The Flood of 09 song from Tuckered Out is going to be available this weekend. The CDs will be available for sale. It's a fundraiser for the Salvation Army. And some locations include the winery, the spirit shop, right here at the KVLY, TV 11, and KX4 studios, over at KFGO, at Pierce Printing, Lee's Hallmark in West Acres, and at Hornbacher's. And here's the red at Fargo, really going to take a jump to 38 feet by next Thursday. And it's 31.71 now, and it's on the climb. Down in southern Minnesota, Iowa on Monday, some pretty good rain. Here's what we're looking for, though, on Tuesday. Keep your eye down in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. By Tuesday night, a big rain event moves out of Wyoming. We'll track into southern North Dakota and South Dakota. We could see a half to 1 inch of rain from that, and that on Wednesday. That's worrisome.
I'd like you to meet two very special friends, Evan and Moira. Even though they are small, both have a big challenge to face. With your support, we'd like to help Evan and Moira beat leukemia. Please consider sponsoring a runner in the upcoming Fargo Marathon. Just go to fargomarathon.com, click on Running for Charity, then the Sponsor a Runner link. Your runner will feel motivated, and best of all, you'll help raise money to help Evan and Moira in their challenge.
Thank you.
Well, unpredictable is one way to describe the Cheyenne River tonight. High flows on the river are rushing into the Cheyenne diversion near Horace. A mile upstream, the Cheyenne is breaking out and going overland. People in the Country Acres area are sandbagging. The neighborhood was filled with water in 97, but no homes were flooded. And now they're worried about what a record crest would bring.
We're pretty warm.
And, you know, from what we understand, there's a lot of water coming our way.
It's like a bowl. And so it just kind of fills in, and there's not much you can do about it. The culverts don't seem to get it out of here as fast as it can come in.
Just call.